Please subscribe mat.com and don't forget to hit the bell icon for more video updates.
Hello everyone. Our today's topic is what is combination and how it differs from the permutation. As we have seen that whenever we talk about the permutation, combination is always there, as they always come together in mathematics when we talk about them, but they differ from each other. How they differ from each other? Let's see. First of all, see what is combination. Combination is basically a selection where order does not matter. So here we have to make the selection and the order should not be considered. So as in case of permutations, we see that permutation is arrangement where order does matter, but in combination it is not. So, or you can also say that number of possible selections. Combination is the number of possible selections. So let's understand its concept with the help of example, and permutation will also be discussed side by side so that you can understand how permutation differs from combination. So here we have an example. Here we have permutation on one side and combination on one side. We will find the permutation as well as combination at the same time so that you can have the clear concept how they both differ from each other. If you are given with the word ABC, let's say it's any word containing the letters ABC, you have to find its permutation. What it will be then? Let's write it. Its permutation can be ACB or BAC or BCA or CAB or CBA. So these are the possible arrangements of the word ABC if you take all the three letters of the word together. So it means order does matter in permutation, that it does matter that whether A is coming before C or A is coming after C or B is coming before A or B is coming after A. So that's why order matters. So we will have multiple permutations or arrangements of the given word if we take all the letters together. So it means you will have 6 permutations. If we see its formula, it will be n factorial divided by n minus r factorial, where n is the total number of letters in the word, that is 3 factorial, and the number of selected letters is also 3, as we have to make the arrangements by taking all the 3 together. So it will be r will also be, so 3 minus 3, it will come out as 6. So it means these two are the same. So we have also got the 6 possible arrangements or the permutation of the given word. But what in case of combination, that you will be asked to find the number of possible combination from the word given by taking all the letters together. So your answer should be straight as only one combination. Now why? Let's see. As order does not matter in combination, so we cannot make 6 arrangements as in case of permutation by changing the position of the letters by taking all the 3 letters of the word together. So it doesn't matter whether we write BAC, whether we write CBA, whether we write ACB or so on. So all the 6 arrangements in permutation is equal to 1 arrangement in the combination. So if we use its formula, it will be easier for you to understand it further, as n combination r is equals to n factorial divided by r factorial into n minus r whole factorial. So n is the total number of letters, so here 3 letters, so 3 factorial. R is the number of letters to be chosen, it is also 3 factorial, and 3 minus 3 factorial 0 factorial, that will be 1. And if we cancel it, what we will get is equals to 1, and it is exactly the same that we have written here, that there will be only one combination of the word ABC, as we will consider BAC, CBA, CAB the same in case of combinations. If you will be asked to select, or you will be asked to find the combinations of 2 letters together from the given word ABC. So if I write here 2 letter combination, it means you have to take 2 letters together out of 3. Let's see what it will be then. So in such a case, what selection we can have? We can have AB or BC or AC, and that's it. But according to the permutation, we can also have BA or CB or CA, because order does matter in permutation. But in combination, order does not matter. So that means in case of combination, we will have only 3 combos. But if we consider the permutation, we will have 6 arrangements, not combination. So this is how combination differ from the permutation, that in combination, order does not matter. We have to take the distinct pairs, as we have to pick the distinct pairs from the given word, and we do not take the order in consideration. So AB will be equals to BA, BC is equals to CB, and AC is equals to CA. So it means in case of combination, these will not be allowed. and we will have only AB and BC and AC. These three repetitions or these three arrangements are removed from the combination in the formula by dividing it by R factorial. So this is the reason why we divide by R factorial in the combination formula, while it is not so in the permutation. So this is how combination differs from the permutation, because order does not matter in combination, due to which the number of selection decreases in the combination as compared to the permutation, and we consider the selections without considering the order as compared to the permutation. So that's all from today's lecture. In our next lecture, we will see how permutation differs from the combination in different way. Thank you.